lot of excitement, a lot of jubilation in the locker room, and just told the guys congratulations. We're in the postseason, and you know, I told them exactly, you know, what I mentioned earlier. You know, we set out to get yourself into the tournament. They've done that, and you know, we just got another opportunity next week.
The Philadelphia Eagles dominated Washington on Sunday, and it was unbelievable. Time of possession, 43 minutes and 19 seconds for the Philadelphia Eagles, 16:41 for Washington. That would explain 89 yards of total offense.
Right.
If you just don't have opportunities to possess the football, you're not going to gain yards. And kudos to the Eagles for that grinded out ball control offense. At one point, Nick Foles had 25 straight completions, tied an NFL record. He exited the game in the fourth quarter with a chest injury. Nate Sudfeld would go on to throw a touchdown pass, 24-0, at least one, maybe more. I don't know. It's 24-0. It was just a complete and total whooping of Washington. 28 for 33 was Foles, 221 yards, two touchdowns, and a pick. There was a pick early, but he shook that off and, again, went on to complete 25 straight passes. And I know we talked earlier about the Bears, and they're going to be a tough matchup for anyone.
Right.
But the one team I don't want to see right now is the Eagles, because there's something about the Nick Foles Eagles. You said it perfectly 2 weeks ago. Carson Wentz is a better quarterback, but when Foles plays, the Eagles are a better team, period.
Yeah, the Eagles play to their strengths of their team more instead of being infatuated with the skills of the quarterback, which I do think was part of the reason.
Isn't that on the coach, though?
It is, definitely. They are just as much to blame because they're the ones that got infatuated with Carson Wentz's skill set and said, wait, forget about our big offensive line and our run game and some of the other things that we do really well. But, yeah, that was a bludgeoning yesterday. I was just saying before we came back on air, I mean, I feel like watching all these games yesterday, I only saw a few plays of the Redskins offense total, because every time I looked over, the Eagles had the ball, and it was like slow death. I mean, some of these drives, 19 plays, 87-yard drive, that took 11 minutes and 49 seconds. I mean, that is unbelievable. I mean, some of the stats in this game, and just the stat line in general, 0 for 9 on third down by the Washington Redskins. Yeah, the Eagles, it was just, you know, stick the knife in 1 inch at a time, and they just slowly dominated the football game. Short completions, a little run here and there, and then, of course, the Redskins' offense was totally outmatched and outclassed and could not do anything.
Well, because Josh Johnson was the quarterback.
Yeah, certainly.
I mean, think about it.
Yeah.
Washington chose Josh Johnson over Colin Kaepernick. The Titans chose Blaine Gabbert over Colin Kaepernick. How much better off, and I know we're talking Washington, Philly here, but how much better off would the Titans have been last night if it was Kaepernick instead of Gabbert?
I mean, yeah, better off for sure, because Gabbert was certainly one of the weaknesses of the Titans in that game.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.